Hi all, it's Jack from Preact here, and today we're going to be taking a look at one of our custom web portals. While Microsoft do provide Power App portal templates, we sometimes find that these don't suit every usage scenario. Often, there are three main reasons why an organization would choose to deploy a custom portal rather than using a Power Apps portal. These are the ongoing cost of licensing, UI requirements, and integration options. Let's start off with costs. A custom portal offers a lower monthly usage cost compared to Power Apps web portal licensing. A basic Power Apps portal can be set up with a relatively low upfront cost, however these are billed by logins over a 24-hour period. Depending on how many logins you have per month, this can start to get expensive. While the cost of the initial portal setup is attractive with a Power Apps portal, organisations often ask us how they can lower the ongoing monthly cost of their web portal. This is where custom portals come in, because we can build a portal on the Microsoft Azure platform, which avoids the additional cost for logins. This is especially cost-effective if your organization's portal has hundreds or thousands of users logging in each week. Custom portals do typically involve higher upfront cost, but their significantly lower monthly cost is frequently a crucial factor. Price is not the only reason why you may want to look beyond Power App portals. Custom portals include the same capabilities as Power App portals, but also provide a more flexible end product. As these portals are built from the ground up, it allows us to use modern technologies and approaches that allow us to expand on what these portals can do. Do you have specific UI requirements? Well, a custom portal can help you do that. We've also seen in previous deployments that a custom portal will often increase performance too. So, let's take a look at one of our custom portals. This is a portal that we've previously built for a customer, and it's a great example of the type of things we can do with custom portals. We're currently on the login page for the portal, and as you can see already, we've gone for a really clean, modern design. Upon entering our details and clicking the sign-in button, we're brought to the main page. Here, we can set this to show a number of things, but in this case we have our latest announcements and our Twitter page. In the top right-hand corner, you'll also be able to see that we have a profile button. Clicking the profile button would allow us to change our details for the portal, such as name, address, and any other details that are required, and this would automatically update in Dynamics 365. This portal contains sales and service. We can allow customers to make new orders, as well as make inquiries that come into Dynamics' cases. Let's take a look at how this works. To create an order, we go ahead and click on the Place Order button, and here we can fill out all of the relevant details. Once we've filled out all of our relevant details, we can go ahead, scroll to the bottom, and click Submit. Now that I've clicked the Submit button, this data has been entered into Dynamics 365, and I can see all of my other related orders here. We also have some other entities in this portal, such as inquiries. If we go and take a look at inquiries, we can currently see a list of all of my inquiries, which in this case links to cases in Dynamics 365. If we click into one of these cases, we can go in and we can see all of our case details. From here, we can download any details relating to this inquiry, and we can also go ahead and update the case directly from the portal if we need to. As you can see, we're able to replicate any Microsoft portal features and much more. I hope this quick demo has given you an insight into what we can do with custom portals, and if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to get in touch.